So security planning, of course, has to address this question of what sort of controls make the most sense, you know, given our assets and given our threat posture and so on. So what are some of these controls? So first thing that you have to worry about is identity and access management. This should come as no surprise because we've been talking about authentication. That tells us who is making a request for any kind of resource we have in the system. And then we have access management. So identity access management is a buzzword you hear all the time. Access management basically says if somebody is making a request for a resource, do they have permission to access that resource? So credentialing is essentially deciding that this person is, we're not going to worry about what you need to show up with to show who you are. And based on that, they're going to create an account for you and they're going to decide what kind of access should be granted to you. Using passwords, then, for example, you may have password policies. You know, how long the password has to be, how frequently it has to be changed. We talked about the Georgia Tech policy, for example. Some places may have multi-factor authentication, for example. They may require that you have a token in addition to a password and things like that. Then we have our assets we are talking about. We have networks and we have hosts, servers and desktops and so on. So we have to have defenses for those as well. So we may have firewalls to control what comes into our network or what leaves our network. We may have intrusion detection and prevention systems to look at the traffic with their network level, then look at network traffic or host activity and so on, and decide if there is something suspicious that may be going on. Another control or solution we may require is that people have antivirus systems running on their machines. People talk about their effectiveness and question how good they are. But there's not going to be one solution that takes care of everything or one control that takes care of everything. They all sort of help you increase the level of assurance, as we say, that you are secure. And so we may require these. If people access our systems and networks from outside, we may require that we have a VPN solution, a virtual private network solution. If they bring your own devices, that may necessitate something else. We know that the software, we're talking about systems and controls, so the software we run on our systems, vulnerabilities may be discovered and patches may become available. And when we talk about controls, I think we're talking about sort of technological controls. These examples, of course, password management or identity management, firewalls and so on, sort of look like those. But another control is how do we educate our users? So this could be, for example, some sort of periodic thing you run. We've seen many companies, for example, to educate their employees so they don't fall for phishing attacks monthly, or they have these things where they send you an email, and if you fall for it, this is not a real attack. This is sort of used to train and educate you that you shouldn't be falling for those kind of things.